Hello, and this is so weird starting in English. Hello and welcome. If you don't know me, I'm Sid. I am an American and I live in Spain. Not gonna call myself an expat because why do Americans only define themselves as expats when I'm an immigrant? I migrated to a different country. I guess Americans, we just like to be a little bit special. And we are.
Yes, we are.
But so, anyways, this is my first time back in English after 2 years on YouTube in Spanish. And I'm really looking forward to the adventures that we're gonna have together. I really think that these 2 years on YouTube in Spanish have given me a lot of perspective about Spanish culture. And like, I just wanna have some fun with this, and I don't think that I need to take it that
seriously.
So this is gonna be a video about some of my favorite things about living in Spain. And we're gonna start with number one, which is that I can literally just walk down my stairs, go to a supermarket, or go get coffee in the morning, and I don't have to drive. This was a huge source of anxiety for me living in the States, especially living in California, where I had to take my car everywhere. Even though technically, like, I could walk to the Ralphs, but it was 30 minutes walking downhill, and then I would have to walk uphill on the way back. And yeah, I did do that a couple of times with my roommate, and it just, you know, it doesn't hit the same. So I just wanted to share a couple of my fave things in Spain. Things that I could improve in Spain: living in a slightly bigger space so I don't have to keep the money jar on the floor. The main thing here that I wanted to point out is how much money I have to grab to go get a coffee. So obviously in the States, I was paying minimum four, maybe just a coffee. It was three at like a specialty store, something like that. I don't know. In California, I paid five normally. And that's a latte or a cold brew. So here in Spain, today I think I'm gonna order a double espresso latte. But here's the thing. Normally, a cafe con leche, which is a latte, would cost between 170 and 2 euros. If we're talking about a coffee that is over 2 euros, that's a bit expensive. So sometimes I order a cortado, which is an espresso with a little bit of milk. So it's like a very small latte. It's really small. And then we have a cafe solo, which is just espresso. But for that, if you're not used to it, like, you definitely need to add the sugar. So I'm going to grab 3 euros just to be safe. But honestly, I was like, oh my God, that's like way too much. Like, I don't need 3 euros to order a coffee. This isn't necessarily one of my favorite things, but it is something to note, and you will repeatedly see this in the videos. You must have your keys with you. You close the door and it locks, and that is a huge difference from the States, and I have made the mistake of not having my keys with me, and it would have cost like 150 euros, and a friend I know got scammed, and they charged him like 500 because he's not from here. Okay, remember how I said 2 euros is expensive? Well, I ordered un doble espresso con leche, and it was €1.80.
Yay!
And I thought because it's a doble espresso, I was gonna, you know, pay a little bit more, like maybe like 20 cents, 30 cents, but no. That's so good. Now that we finished el doble espresso, I think that I want to go for a walk. Like, this is probably one of the main reasons why I haven't returned to the US. So let's go for a walk and I'm gonna show you. But first I want to get changed. Let's go. Okay, so we made it to our destination. Let's go see what my second favorite thing about living in Spain is. Okay, so obviously this is something that we have in very specific places in the States.
Pedestrian walkway.
So like, I just walk down my stairs and now I'm on a pedestrian walkway. And I mean, obviously that does depend where you live in Spain. but the majority of the cities and pueblos are designed for people. They're not designed for cars. And Barcelona, I think, has done a really, really amazing job with that. Like, as you can see, there's bicyclists, there's electric scooters, you can walk here. There are very little cars that pass through a lot of these streets. And actually, this is one of the streets that was made only pedestrian in the last, like, 3 years. Yeah, it's just like, this is definitely something that I love about Spain, and I would not trade this part of my life here for that part of my life in the US. Last thing to note with this is that Europeans are just like, what do you mean? Like, this is normal. And I'm like, yeah, this is normal for you, but this is not normal for me. There are initiatives in Los Angeles to put in more bike lanes or put in more pedestrian walkways, but that's really not gonna happen. So that's not the same here. Like, the city wants to make it work for everyone, and the fact that they're are a lot more opportunities for affordable housing and for governmental support and help that also permits the city to maintain a more, like, it pertains to the people. It doesn't pertain to only those who are in positions of power, if that makes sense. Like, yeah, there are economic differences, but I think that the main thing is that the quality of life is higher for everyone instead of just a few. So let's just go for a little walk, and I'm gonna show you like what it actually looks like to walk from place to place, and I don't even have to take the metro on really nice days or public transport, even though that's gonna be the third thing that I love about Spain. Okay, just a small detail, but it's a little person, it's not a hand. So peatonal is pedestrian. So if you hear that word, just know. Peatones are the people. So those are the pedestrians. But yeah, we love a good only pedestrian street. The Europeans tell me I'm so American. And I'm like, well, Americans, we have cars. And we get our licenses when we're 16. So I had freedom 2 years before all of you. Other things that are different and that we love about pedestrian only streets is that the tourists can just conglomerate on the street and they're not in the street. Why is English like that?
Yeah,
but no, seriously, tourism is a problem in Barcelona. The residents have to deal with it, and it is frustrating because even though they're only pedestrian streets or walkways, like, they're big, but they're not that big.
They're not American sized.
So when the tourists come, there's just a lot, and we're all kind of like stuffed in the same place, and the metros are just really packed. Yeah, just something to consider.
This is the Gaudi house, so look at it.
It's not just about the pedestrian walkways, but it's also about the number of carril bicis that there are in the city. And so that's what I'm gonna do right now. I'm gonna go grab a bicycle. That is the third thing that I love about living in Spain, is the public transport, and that it's safe to ride a bicycle here. So yeah, I think this is one of the things that I really love. However, of course, it could be improved. I think that there are a lot of people who don't look both ways before they cross the street, and that is a problem. The thing is when people here don't respect the signs, obviously that creates tension. It does create conflict, and it is just, you know, like, don't cross when it's on red, because there are like 6 or 7 different ways that the cars or bikes or like skateboards could be coming from. But yeah, no. Love riding a bike. It just gives you like a different mode of transport. So yeah, we can definitely say that thing number three is that I love the bikes in the city, and the public transport is really good. You just have to be careful again. Yeah, no, I think it's a great way to move to the city. And this is true in most cities in Spain. They've all implemented a city-funded bicycle system. And so this one, for example, in Barcelona, is 50 euros a year, and you can grab any mechanical bike that you want. And if you want an electric bike for the first 30 minutes, it's 35 cents. But that's so freaking cheap. And so for me, it's easier to rent this service or use this service than to buy my own bike, especially because it doesn't fit in my apartment. Okay, I have to show you guys my fourth favorite thing about living in Spain. So right now it's 6:50. It's the beginning of March and it's light out. That's amazing. We haven't even arrived at what is technically spring. It's the end of winter, and this whole last month of February, like, I've really, really felt the changing of the season.
and just how much easier it is to exist here in winter. I don't feel that seasonal depression that I felt in California, where, yeah, it was light out at like 6 or 6:30 in the morning, but it got dark at 5. And that was really difficult, especially when I was driving to and from work in the evening. And also, like, the thing is there is that at night, like, life kind of stops. Like, you don't really want to go out in the dark there. And here it's like life doesn't even stop even if it is dark. That really helped get me through all of winter was just the community aspect of living in Spain, how people still go out even if it's winter, not in spring yet. But the thing is like, it's amazing. Like, it's gonna be 7, 7:10, 7:15, and that's the last light.
Okay, and the very last thing that I love about living in Spain, in this video at least, is being able to go out on a Wednesday. And obviously, you can go out on a Wednesday in the States, but I literally just walk down my stairs and I'm at a bar. And obviously that depends on what part of the pueblo that you live in. Like, there are a lot of areas that are more residential, but the thing is that you're no more than a 20-minute walk from the center or from, like, civilization. I'm gonna go with that as number 5. I think that that has also really changed my perspective on life these past 2 years and how I've been able to relate to the community and, like, really keep up my friendships, because it's just so much easier to meet up when you all kind of live a bit closer. And especially in Barcelona, like, it's really well connected. So the farthest they'll go is like 40 minutes in metro. And like, I cannot complain about 40 minutes in metro. There's no excuses. There's a lot less risk involved with going out here. It's like so much safer as well to walk home at night. Especially as a female, I feel so much safer living here than I ever did in the US. Don't feel like I have to watch my back. Like, yeah, in Barcelona, they say it's all dangerous, but I mean, I'm not putting myself in dangerous situations either. I am conscious of what's happening around me, and, you know, like, I'm grateful that nothing has ever happened. So yeah, I'm gonna do the last outfit change.